Hello, it's July 14th, 2010. My name is Reginald. I'm also known as Dimcad. The president's poll numbers are dropping. According to CBS, 44% of Americans approve and 44% of Americans disapprove, getting pretty close to that 40% mark. 52% of Americans believe that the president hasn't done enough to address the economy. I don't think it's the president's responsibility to address the economy, although I do believe he's done things that has hurt the economy. 51% believe that the effects of this recession will last at least another 2 years or longer. Now, when they comment on his economic policies, 13% believe his policies have helped them, 23% believe that the policies have hurt, and 63% believe that his policies have had no effect. Well, this shows you how Americans think that the government's responsibility is to really influence the economy for the positive. I mean, the government can't really save an economy, but anyway. U.S., U.K., and Canada no longer has AAA rating credit ratings from China's credit rating agencies. Well, China has downgraded the U.S. and U.K. and whatever, and basically they're losing faith in our ability to pay back our debts, and we're not really taking it very seriously. Although, you know how Americans are. We don't take anything seriously until there's like a big crisis, so... Okay, U.S. retail sales fall 0.5% in June. This is the second consecutive month that we've had a decline. This is after seven consecutive months of increases. So retail is starting to dry up a bit. Study shows that many doctors will not blow the whistle on their colleagues, whether they're incompetent, addicted to drugs, alcoholic. A lot of them will not report on their fellow doctors. A surprising 17% of doctors surveyed had direct personal knowledge of impaired or incompetent physicians in their workplace. This is according to a Harvard Medical School study. One-third of those doctors had not reported the matter to authorities, such as hospital officials or state medical boards. The findings appeared in Wednesday's Journal of American Medical Association. Quite fascinating. That's a lot of doctors who are impaired or screwed up. This study is based on a 2009 project which they interviewed 1,891 practicing U.S. doctors. So gives you something to think about next time you go to the doctor. I'm just kidding. Okay, Singapore expects GDP to grow up to 15% in 2010. That sounds awesome. Although I would rather have a civilization that has slow, steady growth instead of having these big spurts, because with big spurts, you know, it's kind of hard to adapt to when those spurts end. I don't know, just my opinion. Flint, my hometown, where I'm at right now, Flint, Michigan, had the highest aggravated assault rate in 2009. The city is looking to solve its violence problem. Well, we had a total of 1,527 aggravated assaults in Flint. Wow. Yeah, that's 13.7 assaults per 1,000. That's the highest among communities with populations over 100,000. Now, let me put this into perspective. This is more than Detroit, more than St. Louis, more than Baltimore. The other ones are more like 8.7 to 12.23 per 1,000 in 2009, but we blew them away. Wow. Speaking of Flint, we're considering removing a gun control ordinance that's basically illegal. We do that a lot. We create ordinances that contradict state law. So, like I said about the guns here in Flint, police officers... They go by their own city law that says that you can't have open carry in Flint, Michigan. And the council is discussing whether they should remove their illegal city ordinance. Michigan's an open carry state, and the city of Flint decided to make it illegal. Yeah, okay. Councilwoman Jackie Pobler voted against allowing this change. Her quote was, "I don't care what the state wants us to do on this. I still feel it's wrong. People don't understand it. It's just opening up a can of worms." So basically you're saying that you don't care what the law says. you're going to vote against it because that's what you think, your opinion above the law. Gotcha. Okay, Philly crunch, high jobless rate. Interesting. This is a type of article I think people should really, really read. Basically, it talks about a couple, Erin, and her husband and her kids. She lost her job when her husband lost his unemployment benefits, and all happened within a 24-hour period. She talked about how she's going to work. Her son is 12, is looking for some type of job. Her 6-year-old daughter, Kayla, is looking for some type of job. Her husband's looking. He has medical problems, actually. So he can't do his manual labor stuff. So, you know, quote, "I feel like a loser. I'm 35 years old. People think I like taking my daughter out of dance classes because I can't afford them. Do they think I enjoy not being able to buy my kids the things they want? I want to work. I'm trying." And that's a story we're going to hear over and over and over. Here's another story. "I was laid off in August 2008. I'm worried about the future. I am a mother of 3 children." This is an audio-video producer. "I have no problem working or seeking employment. Many times I have not even received a response to the resume I submit. I have gone on interviews only to get disappointed. My husband and I are fortunate to be able to move in with my 81-year-old mother-in-law. But how sad is that? I apply for jobs and nothing happens." This is Gail Hansen. "Who wants to hire a 59-year-old woman? My answer is nobody. I have years of experience, excellent references, and nothing to show for it." I believe that's a trend we're going to see all across this country. And just to give you perspective on this recession. At this point, well, the largest recession we've had was in 82 and 83, since the Great Depression. That was during the Reagan administration. The average level of unemployment for during that time reached 12.3 weeks. That was a record. Now it's more than 23 weeks. 23 weeks. More than twice. About twice the old record. This is not just a recession, people. And if you can't get there by now, I don't know what to say. Anyway, went to the library, picked up a book called Wastelands, Stories of the Apocalypse. I read the first story by Stephen King, and I gotta tell you, I'm enjoying it a great deal. Alright, so what are you guys reading? All right, have a good day. Take care. Remember that the future belongs to those who prepare for it today. Bye.